probably the most famous, most popular concerto of Rachmaninoff, one of mostly played piano concerto of all times. In 1897 was premiere of his first symphony. Glazunov, great Russian composer, conducted the symphony, and the premiere was disaster. So bad for Rachmaninoff, he didn't compose after that almost 3 years. That was really depression. He met a doctor, his name is Nikolai Daly. He just told him that he will be healthy, he will have a lot of force, he will write new piano concerto. And I don't know how much Rachmaninoff paid for this doctor, but the result was that he became really healthy and he started to write a second piano concerto. The music seems like to be just okay, it's come from heart, it's just from creation, but not at all from construction, it seems. But it's wonderful if you search the score, how interesting the construction is. In these bars which I played, it's already material for almost one third of concerto. So motif in development, first movement. In the culmination of first movement, when the orchestra plays theme as march, Jana plays the same motif. From these five notes, if you don't search the score, you cannot remark it, and maybe it's good because the music seems like just he brought it from his heart and immediately found the way to your heart. And maybe that's the most important, this music. Begins in the same tonality. So concert is C minor, second movement starts in C minor and make modulation into E major. Melody, which is very popular, I think it's used in pop songs. I think Celine Dion sings this, and probably in some films it's used. It's wonderful lyrical melody, which also has some adventures in this second movement. Finale starts in a tonality of slow movement in E major and immediately modulates back to C minor. Thank you. second theme reminds a little bit on the second theme of first movement with even more real oriental element. This theme at the end of finale sounds in a big culmination. Actually, the most power orchestration of all five concerti are in the number two. So the culmination was really explosive. So the only pianist who could really go through the orchestra was Rachmaninoff himself with his hands and his force.